Nice of you to join us. Today's topic is stairs and railings. This is the sketch for a small staircase including a railing, and to build it we will first start the stairs function. The stairs dialog opens and we select the bottom and the top line, which is the beginning and the end of the staircase. We immediately get a preview. I think the staircase is a bit too narrow, but that's no problem, we can adjust it by changing the step size. That looks better. Another click on configure opens the menu where we can now define the stair parametrically. In the position tab we can control where the stair should be positioned on the line. Here, however, the width corresponds to the length of the line and we can go directly to the extensions tab. Here we define a platform by the top extension. So we select horizontal and enter an appropriate value, for example 1000 millimeters. With the bottom extension, we add a vertical one with a height of 180 millimeters. Looking at the preview, I think the stairs are a bit too steep. So I shorten the landing to 800 millimeters. Yes, that looks better, and the angle of about 31 degrees fits too. You can also see in the preview that the first step is too high due to the bottom extension. Here in the Steps 1 tab, we can fix this by adding an additional step. At the top, we know that the floor is 20 millimeters thick. So we also set this offset to distribute the steps appropriately. The stair is now defined and can be inserted by clicking execute. Okay, we have the stairs, but the railings are missing. Clicking on railing opens the dialog. We have different templates that are mounted from the top or from the side. I choose a railing with side mounting. The railings in SolidSteel parametric are template based, which means you have complete freedom in designing your railings. You can create complicated templates with glass inlays or very simple steel railings, both residential and industrial, it doesn't matter. For placement, we can select just a face, or a face and an edge. In our case, this one face of the stair stringer is sufficient because the top direction of our model matches the global top direction that we can set in the settings. However, we can now see that the blue z-axis of our coordinate system is pointing in the direction of the steps, which in this case is the wrong way round. We activate flip at offset, and now the z-axis on which the railing is offset outwards points in the right direction. We move the start offset a little, otherwise the first support would be exactly where the screws of the first step are. For now, let's just create the railing without any further settings, as we can change it at any time. We see how the template is adjusted to the new conditions, such as the angle of the stairs and the length, and there is the finished railing. Now of course we have the problem here at the second and the second to last post that the mountings are in the way of the steps. But that's not a problem, because on the one hand we can easily make adjustments, and on the other hand I think there are too many posts for such a short railing anyway. To change it, we open the railing dialog again, click on the change tab and select the railing. Now, in the parameters section below, we can specify that we only want to have two segments, and increase the number of bars in the segments to 8 since the segments are now wider. All other dimensions are also part of this template. For example, we could also change the height of the handrail, or how far the handrail protrudes, and of course all kinds of offsets. The variables offered by a template depend of course on the quality of the template. I'll leave it at those two changes, confirm and the update will be done. Looks good, no more conflicts between the railing bolts and the step bolts. Let's extend the railing here at the top of the platform. We do it the same way as before. That is, open the railing dialog, switch to the Create tab, set type to the side railing and select the face. As we can see, SolidSteel Parametric has remembered the last entries, so the flip option is still activated. We set the start offset to 0 here so that the posts are exactly on top of each other, and we can offset the end slightly so that there is room to mount the last post to the profile. Of course, we don't need 4 segments on the short section. One with, let's say, 4 rods will do the job. We can confirm this. This looks good, but we still need to tweak a few things. We had defined via the start offset that the left post of the railing is exactly above the last post of the first railing. This double post must of course be removed because otherwise it would also appear in the parts list. To do this, we go to the pattern here, see that the post is element 1. Select all the parts involved and suppress them. A miter cut is still needed at the top of the handrail, but this can be done quickly. This completes the railing on one side, which will now repeat on the other side. Select Side Railing in the Railing dialog, select the face. The flip option must of course be disabled on this side. Offset here below was 150 mm. We had two segments with 8 rods each and we can confirm with execute. Now the railing is built in exactly the same way as the other side, only mirrored. Another short railing at the top for the platform. Here the offsets were 0 mm to the lower handrail and 120 mm at the end. Then we had one segment with 4 rods and we can confirm this here as well. Again, there is one post too many, in this case it is now element 2, because we have aligned the railing from left to right. Another miter cut between the handrails, and our staircase including the railings is finished. This could be, for example, a small entrance staircase for a building that for some reason has a raised front door. Now including a simplified house wall. Here at the wall we can see that the handrails are too long. We can quickly fix this with a face cut. We select the face on which we want to cut, then the handrail and confirm. We do the same for the second handrail. Good. Now we will automatically assign position numbers. To do this, we start the BOM management and run the equal part detection by clicking on refresh. This takes a moment, and we now have the list of position numbers sorted by welded assemblies, beams, and so on. If you would like to know how to create automated shop drawings for such a staircase, just start the video suggested here. Thanks for watching and see you next time.